In the last video, we went over the line and polyline tools, and in this video, we're going to go over the circle and the arc tools. So I have a couple of little demos laid out on my screen. You don't have to do these step by step with me, but I just wanted to kind of have some things set up a little bit so that way it could work a little bit faster. So we'll start with the circle command. The circle tool is located right here in your toolbar, and that little arrow underneath the word circle means that there are different types of circles that we can use when drawing. So we're going to look at a couple of them, but the one we'll most commonly use is this center radius. And anytime you hover over a tool without clicking on it, it'll give you a little preview and explanation of what that tool does. So I'm just going to use the center radius one, and I'll pan over so that stuff is off the screen for now. And really all you're gonna do with this tool is you just click where you want it to start, and then you're going to type in whatever you want your radius of the circle to be. So whatever it may specify in your practices of how big the circle should be radius-wise or diameter-wise. So I'll just give it a radius of 4, which let me use these numbers for it, 4, enter, and I've made a circle with a radius of 4. So let's look at that again, but this time I'm going to use the keyboard shortcut. So the keyboard shortcut for a circle is the letter C, enter, and we can see in my command bar that it is asking me to specify the center point of the circle, and then it's giving me those grayed out options. Let me just move the little keyboard thing up a little bit. Oh, there we go. But it's giving us some of these grayed out options where we can switch for different types of circles, because by default that keyboard shortcut does bring us into a center radius or a center diameter, but we could switch it out if we wanted to using the keyboard shortcuts. I'm just going to continue on with a center point, so I'm just going to click randomly right here for my center point. And now my command bar is prompting me to specify the radius of the circle, and I could switch it over to diameter if I wanted to by clicking on that grayed out option or typing in the letter D. One thing you'll notice is here in these brackets is the number 4, and what that means is that is the default. So if I hit enter without clicking on anything else or typing in any specific amount, it is going to, by default, and I'll show you, make a circle that has a radius of 4. And that's because the very last time I used the command, that's the size I used. And so it's assuming I want to do it again unless I specify otherwise. So again, I'm just going to launch the circle command, C, enter. And I'll specify a center point for the circle. This time I'll snap it to that center point. So I'll make two circles that are concentric. This time I'm going to actually say that I want to do a diameter option. So I can either click on the word diameter in the toolbar or type in D, enter. And this time I'll give it a diameter of 10. Whoops, I'm using the wrong keys again. 10, enter. And now I have two circles that have the same center point. One of them has a radius of 4 and the other has a diameter of 10. And if I click on either of them, I'll get information about that circle and its specific size right here in the properties panel, which again, you'll find things for your certification exam. They might ask for you to make a circle, and then, you know, what is the circumference or what is the area of it? And rather than trying to calculate it, you can find that information quickly in the properties bar. I'm just going to hit escape to unselect that circle and just show you a couple of the other types of circles that might exist. So I'm just going to pan over here. Now, if I have a circle that I need to like fit perfectly in between two lines, what I could do is maybe draw a line in between the two of them, figure out what the length of that line is, calculate what half of it is, and then like draw a circle based on the midpoint of that line. And I could do it that way, and I'll get the same end result, so it wouldn't be wrong. But a faster way I could get kind of this end result of this circle sitting here would be to use a different type. So if I click on that little drop down, the fastest way for a scenario like this would be to do a two-point circle, where I can specify two endpoints, or rather two quadrants of that circle, and then it'll automatically fill it with whatever size, radius, or diameter it might be. So if I click on that option, we can see that my toolbar has skipped over that specify center, and it's automatically gone into a two-point. And so I'm just going to click on one endpoint, to the next one, and it'll just fill it in kind of automatically without having to make any of those calculations. One of my favorite types of circles, or specialty types of circles, is the tan-tan radius circle, which is really useful for filling in some of these curved corners. Though there are other shortcuts that can help out with that we'll go over in the modify portion of the course, so namely the fillet tool. But with a tan-tan radius circle, you define two lines the circle is tangent to, and then whatever you want the radius of the circle to be. So I'll go into my circle drop-down, and I'll choose the tan-tan radius option. And with that, I just need to select one line I want it to be tangent to, so it'll give me that tangent snap point. And I'll just click on one line, click on another line, doesn't necessarily matter where you click on them, and then it's saying, and what would you like the radius to be? So in this one, I'll give it a radius of 1, enter, and it'll find that circle and where the center point would fit perfectly. So think back to when we were doing hand drawings and we were making those curved corners or those curved edges. This is that same result, it's just kind of a expedited process a little bit thanks to the computer. And so I did one here too, where I didn't have to calculate where the center of this circle would have to be. I could definitely say, well, if I want, and let me just click on this circle and delete it, using the delete key on my keyboard, I could say, well, let me draw a line that comes from this corner out 1, enter, and then move my cursor up, 1, enter, escape to end the command, and then come into the circle tool, and then select my center point and my radius. I'm getting the exact same end result as that tan-tan radius did, but this is just a little bit of a longer way to get there. So I encourage you to kind of play around with some of those different circle options and tools to find which one you like best and which one's most comfortable for you. Next thing I want to go over are just some of the different types of arcs you could draw and use. So I personally don't use arcs very often. I like to draw circles and kind of cut my circles up, but if you feel comfortable using arcs and drawing arcs, then by all means, draw your arcs and your curves. So the arc tool is located right here, and it's keyboard shortcut A. We'll start the arc tool. I usually will choose an arc if I'm drawing one from this drop down, because there are lots of different arcs we could use. And based on the information we know about our drawing and about our curve, is going to define which type of arc we use. So we might know where the arc starts and where its center point is and where it ends. We might know where the arc starts, where it ends, and what its radius is. We might know the length of the arc. So depending on exactly what we know will be which type we use. Most of the time, if I'm drawing an arc, I'm using the start, center, end, or center start end, and a lot of times start end radius of, I know the two endpoints of where it starts, where it ends, and then the overall size of the radius of that arc. So this is the type that I use quite often. So we'll see it in an example here. I'll click on the start end radius option, where I'm just going to click on one endpoint I want my arc to start at, the other endpoint I want it to end at, and then what radius do I want it to be? And so I'm just going to give it a radius of 5, enter. And now I have an arc that sits nicely in those corners. So I'll use this type sometimes when I need to make something that looks like this. Now again, when we get into the modify commands, I am going to show you kind of a shortcut of how you could get a shape that looks like this. But if I want to kind of curve corners or edges like this, I would start with just a plain shape. And then I would either draw guidelines up. So I would go into the line tool, and I believe I gave these a radius of 2. So I'm just going to draw from down there, up 2, enter, hit escape. Back into the line tool, click to start, over 2, enter, escape, because that's just giving me some guidelines, some snap points to reference for when I make my arc. Another thing I could do is I could click on the original line and I can click on the grips to stretch them down 2 units. So I'll go down to enter, click on my grip, over 2. No matter what, they're all going to lead me towards that same end result. I could also originally maybe just draw my line 2 units shorter on the top and bottoms. Bunch of different ways I could do it. And for this, I'm actually just going to not even bother typing. I can just click directly to that. And I'll take these guidelines I drew and just use the delete key on my keyboard to get rid of them. So now I have kind of all of the straight lines in there, and now I can add my curves in. So again, for my arc, I'm going to do a start end radius, where I click one snap point I want to start at, snap point I want to end with, and then I define what I want my radius to be. So I'll do 2, enter, and then we'll just add that curve. And I'll say where I want it to start, where I want it to end, and what I want the radius to be. Back into the arc tool. You do want to be careful when you're using a start end radius of which way you select. So see for here, for example, because I went I guess kind of counterclockwise with my selection, it's gonna invert it, which maybe that is what I want, but in this scenario it's not. So I'm just gonna control Z to undo that. Start and radius, enter, and to finish up the corner, start and which, whoops, I made the same mistake, so let me hit escape. Start and radius, enter. And it does take some practice and some feeling out to get accustomed to it, but if you do make a mistake, just remember Control Z to undo and then try it again. And practice makes progress. So now, up on Canvas, there are same circle and arc practices for you to complete. When you are done, make sure you are saving your work as circle arc practice and upload it to Canvas. And make sure you note the rubric for the assignment for how you will be graded and evaluated. And if you have any questions about the circle tool or the arc tool or anything at all regarding the assignment, please let me know.